Good morning. Well, is it morning? What time is it? It is. Come on, work. Okay. It is 11:30 a.m. It is a busy day here at Disneyland because as I was walking in, it said no reservations and the crowds. There's a line to get into DCA, which is exactly where I'm going because it's the beginning of California Adventure, Food and Wine. Very excited to do this. And I'm shooting some content for Unexpected Magic Vacations. So that is what today is about. Park hopping just started an hour ago because we start park hopping at 11 a.m. here. So that's why there's such a crowd, because it's already gone down quite a bit since I've been here. So let's hop in line and let's see what kind of snacks we can get today. Let's go. All right, guys, I came to a quiet spot to try and gather my thoughts. I'm like half in light, half in shade. I apologize. Lighting is bad. But I have a list of things that I'm going to try today, which is exciting. Hold on a second while I pull it up. All right, I am right by Sonoma Terrace, and it seems like it's just the Corksicle that I want to get my mom something, because she is the woman behind Unexpected Magic Vacations. She sponsored this, so yeah. If there's anything I can mobile order, we're gonna try and do that now. So hang on a second while I do that. I'm absolutely going to get slammed with the copyright on this because they are playing nothing but copyrighted music. I'm right by Avocado Time and there's mac and cheese that I want from there, so we're gonna do that. Sounds good. Just gonna have to deal with what comes at us today. So the first booth I went to was Avocado Time, where I got Impossible Nacho Mac and Cheese, which I'm very excited to try. And then this is good for kids. It is a blackberry lavender lemonade, non-alcoholic. I took a sip because I didn't want it to spill. It's like Country Time, but a little more tart. It's so good. I wish I had grabbed the straw, but alas, I am not smart. So let's take a bite of this, shall we? The guac actually looks pretty good. This is gonna be so filling, but it's damn good. I am very excited about that. Yum. Okay, I'm gonna put my camera away and eat this now. So that's a good start. All right, guys, they have tables set up everywhere. It's so nice. The amount of content creation that is happening in this general like World of Color viewing area, hilarious, amazing, love to see it. So let me create some content and see what I want next. Oh, someone texted me. Okay, I am right across from California Craft Brews, but I don't really want that because it's mostly IPAs, and I was like, I guess I'll try the IPAs, but I don't like them. Someone once described drinking IPAs as the same as drinking black coffee, and you're wrong. You're just wrong for that. It is not the same. They're both pretentious and awful, but one tastes better than the other. I think I'm gonna go... The issue is that mac and cheese filled me up like a lot, which can't complain, that was $7 and totally worth it. But the next booth I think I wanna go to is Cluckadoodle Moo, if you will. And it's got smoked honey habanero chicken wings. I love chicken wings. And a chipotle pineapple bourbon sour that might be a bit much for right now, so I think we'll hold off. But I do want a little drinky drink, or in English, and not Elmer Fudd, a little drinky drink. Let's go to... Oh, let's go to Uncork, California, where they have the Mimosa flight that represents each like major milestones within the Walt Kidney Company, shall we? I love that I can't say the actual name, the Walt Disney Company. So yeah, let's go do that. Let me find where that is as well. I think it's all the way on the left. Let's do that. I got the Century of Magic Mimosa flight. They actually numbered it this year, which is so nice because every year I think I confuse whatever one I get. So, first one is 1923, opening day, not opening day, start of the company. It's Prosecco, white cranberry juice, white peach syrup, and lemon juice. I have fear this is gonna be stupid sweet. bad. It's got headache written all over it, but that's not bad. Second one is 1939, so that's the year Snow White premiered. That's Prosecco, pineapple and orange juice with passion fruit. Oh, it's hog juice. Hog juice mimosa. I like that less. I think I don't like guava. That might be the result. I'm gonna drink all of it because I paid for it. But the last one, 1955, Disneyland opening, and that is Prosecco, dragon fruit, and rose syrup. Scary. Hibiscus water and lemon juice. First one's my favorite. 1923 is my favorite. It's the least, it's like the most neutral. It's still sweet, but it's not overpoweringly sweet. Like the other two taste like, does anyone still drink this but vitamin water? Like sparkling vitamin water? That will definitely give you a headache. Or like Trident tropical fruit gum. That's what they taste like. So I am gonna drink the other two first and then end on the one that I like. But I don't know, overall, like a 4.5 out of 10. I kind of just got it because the Disney history nerd in me was like, get that. And I was like, okay. But it's not my favorite. I kind of knew that. And I'm glad I tried it. So, yeah. I'm going to finish these off. And then, I don't know, putz around. It's what I seem to do best. So, it's no secret. I'm always here by myself for various reasons. But I have had multiple conversations with multiple people who are also here by themselves today. So it is worth noting that coming to Disney by yourself, I've had a couple of drinks and now I'm feeling deep. It's worth noting that coming to Disney by yourself is not weird or awkward. It's actually probably one of the better places to go by yourself. There's always other people to like chat with them because we're all just here trying to have fun. And if it's a festival, people are just trying to eat and drink and be merry. That's my PSA. Don't be afraid to come by yourself. You will have fun. I think I need to walk around and then I'm gonna get some chicken wings. That's what I think I'm gonna do as I finish this last sickeningly sweet drink. Ugh. I don't like mimosas. I'm never getting one again. Where's a Bloody Mary? That's the real question. That is my breakfast drink of choice. Let's get more snacks. So I'm mad at myself because I need to get out of this crowd. This is not smart. Anyway, I was here when they released the 100 stuff and I didn't like any of it. And then my sister showed me the purple hoodie, like the pullover, and I was like, crap, I think I want it. And now it's sold out everywhere. So I have to just wait and keep my eye on everything. It's like, it's the beginning of the celebration. There's no way they're gonna let it just sell out at the beginning and not restock it, right? It's my own fault. When you see something, buy it. I should know that. I've been doing this for what, 6 years now? Ridiculous. All this construction you see behind me, very exciting. It's gonna be San Fran, Tokyo from Big Hero 6. And it's supposed to be open this summer. And I can't wait for summer because I'm tired of being cold, but how exciting. Back in the same spot. This is just the best place to film. And look at that! Love the fun wheel in the background. Okay, what the hell did I even buy? This is the last thing I think I'm gonna do for a little bit. And then, this was expensive. I think this was the most expensive thing I got. No, I'm sorry. That was fine. I thought she said 45 and I was like, well, I ordered it, so I'm gonna pay for it. It was 25. It doesn't have the individual price. Where is my, Oh, please. I have it written on my phone. We're so organized here. Am I even recording? Yes. This is why they call me, just since I'm already at that level. It's worth noting, a certain sibling of mine calls me the one drink wonder because I have one drink and I do not shut up and I get a little silly. So this bourbon's going to hit because do you see the size of it? I'm gonna drink that and then I'm gonna go watch magic happen and just chill. There's no reason to do that. I'm also not gonna chug that. I'm not gonna chug it, because I've got a while. And then I'm gonna sit on Main Street and I'm gonna watch the parade, which excites me deeply. Anyway, so I got the smoked honey habanero chicken wings, and those were $8.50. And then the Chipotle pineapple bourbon sour was $17. Let's just dig in, shall we? Oh wait, I have to take pictures first. Damn it, hold on. Let's do the chicken wings first, because I'm very excited about these. They're a little dry, and they're not as spicy as I thought they would be. Bear in mind, I would say that my spice tolerance is on the high side of good, but like also teetering on mediocre comparatively to people who are like, spice is a regular part of my diet. Well, yeah, I'll say I'm on the high side of good. I wouldn't say I'm like amazing, spectacular, but they're good because they're not super messy. Like I don't have sauce all over my fingers. Let's try this habanero pineapple bourbon thing. Oh, danger. I'm in danger. That is delicious. It's sweet. Then you get like the smoke. It tastes like grilled pineapple. Danger, danger. This is my favorite. 10. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. That was delicious. Oh my God. Wow, that is $17 well spent. All right, we're doing good today. That is exciting. Okay, I'm gonna enjoy these now and enjoy my $25 snack.
Switching quality. This is my phone. Since I don't feel like digging my camera out of my backpack. I need to get more B-roll for the content that I'm making for Unexpected Magic Vacations. And then I'm going to park hop over to Disneyland to watch Magic Happens. And that might be my day. I might get one more thing, but it'll probably be something sweet, like a churro or something. But there is a line for the one I want, so we'll see.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. I like that your favorite character is Jiminy Cricket.
Oh, thank you.
Have a good one.
There are people lining up already, but I am walking into my old work location, the Emporium, to just see if I can even get a little bit. I want that sweatshirt so bad. They have the t-shirt. But not in a large because I want to wear it with bike shorts. Oh, it's just as screwy in here as ever. If you know me, you know why this is not the fit. Like, this fits. No dice. We got mini. Do like that. That. No, no dice. Sad face. Okay. Let's find a snack and go sit down.
Main Street where I can balance my camera on a trash can and get the whole thing for you guys. That will be posted at a later date, but for now I am gonna enjoy my, thank God for this trash can, my cake pop. And
guys, that's gonna do it from me from Disneyland today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. Leave a comment down below, click the subscribe button, click the like button, all those fun things, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.